I'm trying to get ready for Halloween. And I've been having kind of fun poking around a little bit. Apparently, video responses are back. It should be pretty fun. Now, I haven't been watching as many videos as I had been in the past. Without being able to make responses, it didn't really seem like it was worth the bother because you end up sitting there typing in the response thing, and I get tired of it. That, my evil red keyboard gets tired of it too. Can you see my evil red keys? Wah, you know. Actually, I usually leave them blue, but that's beside the point. Anyway, since I am a creature of the web, I've decided to do a little bit of wandering around and see what's going on there out on the internet. So, I don't know. Sounds like fun. I'm just glad the responses are back. Anyway. Hey. What are you sitting there for? Come on, let's go. Ooh, ugly curtains. Who's that? I see the back of a bald head. Ooh, I'm gonna talk. I better keep quiet. So, what's going on in here?
Show game, and I'm tired.
Oh, it's Wingnut.
And one thing probably most people don't know about me on YouTube is that I'm actually really sensitive
I did not know that.
and very emotional
Oh.
towards people,
Wait a minute.
and I'm sure a lot of people are,
What kind of emotion?
but you'd probably be surprised about how much I am. And ESPN2 was showing a story about Monica Korra, Korra, Korra. And it's actually an old story. It's something that happened in December of 2009.
It's an interesting story,
And
though.
she's from Norway. And she came
He's
to
gonna
the
tell it,
United
isn't he?
States. And she went to the school SMU. She's a cross-country runner.
Oh, wait. Hold it right there. I have the pause button. I can do this. SMU, that's Southern Methodist University. That's in Texas. Not too far from here, actually. Granted, I believe there are several campuses, but oh, God. I'm sorry. Go
And
ahead.
I'll put the links in the description box.
You do that.
And the story, what happened was, is this one particular night, she was kidnapped by three men at shortly after 2 o'clock in the morning. She was out with her friends, and they pulled up in a SUV and kidnapped her, drove for about 20 minutes, and then raped her.
You're a lousy storyteller, dude.
Repeatedly.
Hang on, hang on. Hang. Wait. Well, okay, fine. I'll let you get that word out. There. Okay, much better, much better. Oh, look, you're smiling. Oh, that's so great. Oh, by the way, hey Tim. I should have said that. I mean, it's rude of me not to, right? So, anyway, hello from the internets. Timmy, excuse me for a moment while I sit there and explain this, Mr. Wingnut. This what happened was this woman and her friend were on their way walking to a party. Now, being the two of them were both foreigners. And they tried fighting back when the men came, jumped out of the van to try and grab her, and then a gun was pulled on her. And at that point, it was just, "Don't kill me." It was a really horrible case. Incidentally, these people just, as a footnote, had illegally immigrated into the country. They were here illegally. They had a criminal record back home, and these people were criminals, rather serious criminals, I might add, actually. They're currently being investigated for 77 potential murder charges. Pretty serious circumstance here. Sorry, where were you? Go ahead, Tim. I said you can go ahead now. Oh, you startled me.
This is what I'm struggling with.
Okay, what are you struggling with?
But people won't say that what happened to her was absolutely wrong.
What? What people? Of course, what happened to her was wrong. What kind of
I don't
monsters do you think we
understand.
are? You don't understand a lot of things,
I'm
apparently.
tired. I'm
Oh, look at the
generally a
hand.
sensitive person anyway. And here I am watching this show. And I got thinking about atheists who.
You're watching. Hang on. Wait. So you're sitting there watching a story about this woman who was brutally assaulted and treated horribly, that's decided to get beyond it. It's a horrible story, but in part it's a story about overcoming adversity. And you're sitting there thinking about atheists? What the? Go ahead.
To hold on to their supposed atheism, refuse to say that anything is absolutely wrong. How do they do that?
Well,
How do you do that?
for starters, Tim, let me break this down for you. We have brains. The brains send a signal down through the vocal cords, resonate, the sound comes out of the mouth. And at the same point, the problem is you're using the word absolute. You're trying to go for this absolute objective thing you do, aren't you? Aren't you? No? Yes? Well, come on, chew on it some more.
I'll leave links. Probably said that a minute ago. I'll
What's
leave
with the hand?
links,
Get
and
your hand out from behind me. Get the dip, dip, dip.
everyone who
It's
watches it will
distracting.
know.
Hey, don't. Ow, I think I just got hit. Dude, come on.
This is absolutely wrong. And
Yeah?
for anyone to say that it's not absolutely wrong and to strum up some kind of scenario where it would have been right.
You know what the problem with this is, Tim? You're trying to talk about some kind of objective, absolute morality. And if that was true, then these people wouldn't have done it because they would have known it was wrong. Do you understand this? Do you?
It's just foolishness. It's just
No.
foolishness. For those of you who are responding and
No.
getting ready to send a text message or to comment on this video and say,
No, I'm going to stand right here and I'm going to comment in a moment. I've had about enough of this.
give me a crazy scenario where it would be justified.
Well, the thing. No. We don't need to give you a crazy scenario where it would be justified. The thing is, culture can say it's wrong. People can say it wrong. I can certainly say that it's absolutely wrong. But that doesn't mean it's objectively wrong. If it was objectively wrong, then the people that did this would have recognized it as being objectively wrong. Dude, you're not understanding it. We're talking about morality here as a whole, not just simply the good people, but every. Oh my gosh, Tim, Tim, Tim. Oh,
That's
what's the
just
matter with you?
foolishness.
Foolishness, really. So, realizing that different people have different views towards morality is foolishness. Is it now?
That's just foolishness.
Ah, here we go again. Are you going to just keep
It's
repeating
the
yourself?
foolishness of suppressing the truth
What truth?
about God.
Oh, good grief. You mean the God that doesn't exist? You know, no, this isn't saying the Christian God. That could exist, I guess. There's like almost no chance, but who knows? Infinite universe, eh. But at the same point, your God, this one you're talking about, is one that we all know exists. Well, I don't know the existence of any gods, therefore, your God is disproven. Sorry, you've created a falsifiable God concept. Anyway.
And when you say that things aren't absolutely wrong, you expose the folly of your position. I'm sorry, but it's true.
No, it's not. It's because you don't understand what you're being told. In that little noggin of yours, if I could reach through this window, I would just go top, 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 top. Anyway. Sorry, ugh. Oh, dude. Oh, curtains again. Sorry. Oh, let's try that again. I don't know if you need better lighting or what, man, but your house looks kind of. Nah, I'm gonna shut up. I'm not one to talk with that. My area behind me normally looks pretty bad too. Granted, that's because there's no depth of field on my camera. Nah.
Sorry, but it's true.
What's
I'm not sorry.
You're
It
sorry or
is
not
true.
sorry? Figure it out.
Atheism is complete foolishness.
Is it now?
You know right from wrong.
Is this kind of like you're claiming that we know that God exists? Now, the thing is, yeah, we know right from wrong. Not everyone does, clearly, otherwise these things wouldn't happen. Because clearly the people that did this didn't seem to think that there was anything wrong with what they were doing.
You know many things that are absolutely wrong,
Yeah, like you deliberately mischaracterizing atheists, like you deliberately mischaracterize what we're saying when we're talking about this kind of thing. I mean, come on, Tim.
regardless of the situation.
Ugh. You don't understand. You've made this plainly clear. Unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to talk with you about this during that one opportunity I had because we had to have some dipstick come in and decide to start an argument when we finally started having a decent conversation. But leave that on the side. I want to have a talk with you. I want to have a talk with you. I want to have a talk with you over there, Timmy. Timmy, Timmy. Mr. Bible Thump and Wingnut. I want to have a conversation with you about morality. I want, not simply in responses, but I want to have a conversation and try and get this through that little noggin of yours. It's a shame you can't hear me because there's a window in the way, but we'll see if I can get you to hear my words at some point.
You guys who come up with these stupid scenarios, let me tell you a little secret, okay? If you are forced to do an immoral act
What?
by somebody who's immoral, who put you in an immoral position, these stupid
Wait a minute, wait a
scenarios
minute,
you
wait a minute,
guys
wait a
come
minute.
up with.
Wait a minute. I've got to stop you again. If you're forced to do an immoral act, so being raped, being the victim of rape is an immoral act. You do realize that's what you just said, Mr. Wingnut. You just said, okay, let me put this in other terms. I know you have that weird sex hang-up because of this silly book of yours. But let me try and explain this to you a little bit better, okay, buddy? If you're walking down the street and somebody randomly pulls out a gun and shoots you in the freaking face, you have not committed a moral act by being murdered. The same applies to rape. I mean, come on, for crying out loud, that's just, yeah.
It's still wrong. You were
I'll tell you what's
forced, or
wrong.
if those pretend scenarios that you strum up to try to eliminate this absolute knowledge of right and wrong,
I'm gonna have to school you about that too.
these stupid scenarios that you come up with, if they were to ever occur, you would be forced to do an immoral act. You would be forced to do something that's absolutely wrong.
You're an idiot.
There,
I'm sorry, you're an idiot, dude.
let the
You
cat out of the
don't
bag.
freaking
There's your
get it.
answer, YouTube atheists. It's absolutely wrong.
No, what's absolutely wrong is your understanding of morality. You don't get it. You're not likely to get it at this rate either, and that kind of saddens me. Now, I guess I could let you get to the end here, in which you're going to sit there and try and talk about this God that you claim we all know exists, even though we don't. But I'm not going to give you the chance because I've had about enough of this. This might be it for my outing this time. Next time, I think I'll just do a little bit more of a random outing, and maybe you can play a little bit of Where's Waldo next time I do this. But for now, Timmy, for now, Mr. Bible Thump and Wingnut, I'm going to have a little talk about this. Let's head back. There's a penny. Okay, let's have that talk. Now, you see, morality, as much as you may want to claim that it is objective and all this other nonsense, there's a few things I need to point out. First off, Wingnut, is that you made the statement initially, well, I shouldn't say initially, but a while ago in one of your videos, that if, and this is fun. You claim that if morality is subjective, then it can't change. That is what subjective means, is changing, based upon individual perceptions, this kind of stuff. But it can only change. Morality, what it is, can only change if it is subjective. If it's objective, then it's always true, now and forever, etc., which means that all of the moral codes that are in those ancient books that you like to talk about would also be true for all time. And that's a little bit of a conundrum, seeing as morality has changed with the times. For example, in that book, God never specifically says anything against He never specifically says anything against slavery. He never specifically says anything against, well, abortion for one, all kinds of things. For that matter, in classical Judaic law, if the choice is between the mother and the child goes. But I don't really expect you to know that. You're a talking head, and you're going to believe what you want to believe, and you're going to claim all this objective crap. But the simple fact of the matter is, if there was an objective morality, and I'll tell you, at times I almost wish that there was some kind of objective morality out there that was written on our hearts. It'd be nice. However, I mean, I suppose that some people that are religious could claim that it's written on our heart, we just can't read the writing. But that's not what you're claiming. You're claiming that there's this objective morality and we all know what it is. Well, if that's the case, then how come none of us agree on what is and isn't moral in a lot of cases? Now, granted, you always go to the extreme examples. You had that one thing with, you know, is it moral to, is it objectively wrong to use chemical weapons, I think was one of them. And now you're on rape. I mean, dude, come on. From a societal standpoint, from the subjective view of not only the majority of individuals, but as well as that of the society at large, yes, these things are subjectively, objectively wrong. They're considered objectively wrong through the subjective framework. And I've made another video addressing this and trying to explain it to you. I hope you watched it. I tried attaching it to one of your videos, but we'll see about that. I don't know. Let me adjust my camera here. Sorry. Oh, a little too low. Now here's the conundrum that we have here, Timmy. If this was the case, that there was this objective morality and we all knew it, then we would all act according to that. And yes, this particular instance was horrible. There was another instance up in New York City where there were a bunch of Muslim men that had just gotten out of some kind of celebration. I want to say it might have been a wedding. I'm not sure. But they're wandering through Central Park and they see us relatively, by their standards, scantily clad. She was fully freaking clothed. Woman that was out jogging, and lo and behold, what did they decide to do? They decided to seize her and gang rape her. Why? Because according to their morality, her dressing like that meant that she wanted it. That was their morality. That's what they thought was right. Now, if there was some objective morality that we all knew, they wouldn't have thought that way. And you can claim that they're making excuses as much as you want, but no, dude, that's not the way it works. Now, I'm going to explain something to you. I'm going to tell you a story. This is a true story. You see, I've known a hell of a lot of people. I've known a lot of women that were assaulted, whether it be molestation. Would you like to bring up that whole raping children for fun thing that you like bringing up, which I always find somewhat disturbing. But don't worry, I'm not going to build a straw man out of that, even though I certainly could. You see, I've known a lot of women that have been victims. And also due to the background and the places I've been and the people I've met and what have you, I've also met some people that are on the other side of that fence. I've met the offenders. And boy, do I have a story for you, and I hope, seeing as trying to explain it in big words didn't help, I'm going to try and explain this using a story, because then maybe you'll understand what I'm trying to say, okay? This woman that I knew a while back, when she was rather young, she was molested by a cousin. The cousin was only a few years older than she was. And what he would do is he would take her and her little brothers out into the wood by where they lived, and he'd have a shotgun with them, and the two little brothers would be forced to watch while he raped her. Now, he would explain to her each time that this was him training her so that she'd be ready to be a good wife when she got married. Is what he did wrong? Oh, yeah. It is very wrong. Did he think what he was doing was wrong? Well, That's where it gets interesting, because the answer is no. Why? Because his morality wasn't like yours and mine. You see, when he was younger, he was the little brother there with a shotgun pointed at him, being watched, being forced to watch as his older brother raped their own sister. So, what the guy that was raping this young woman was doing was repeating a cycle of abuse. He didn't understand it was wrong. He thought that this was just simply the way things were. This is the way it was supposed to be. Because that's all he knew. Because there was no morality written in his heart telling him that this was wrong. None. I'm sorry, I wish that there was some truth to what you're saying. But he didn't know it was wrong. Because he was brought up believing that, well, this is just what you do. And he repeated that cycle with this girl who was his niece. And it was horrible. Now, luckily, the cycle of abuse ended there. It stopped. They got away from that environment. It was at some point after the mother found out. And the interesting thing is that the little girl, now mind you, she was much older by the time I met her, but at the time she was a child, not even a teenager yet. She hadn't even had her first period, to the best of my knowledge at least. But that little girl didn't know what was happening to her was wrong either. She didn't have that feeling inside of her of knowing because it's written in her heart either. This is just the way it was. It wasn't until later, until after she told her mother, until later, that she found out that this isn't right. And do you understand yet? Wingnut, do you get it? Do you understand? And it's because of instances like this, as well as others, in which people do horrible, horribly immoral things. Things that I would say are absolutely wrong and immoral. Things that I would dare even get so close as to say that I would like to consider them to be objectively wrong. The problem is objective is outside. Absolutely objectively wrong is external of us. And that kind of wrong isn't written on our hearts. It's something we get from those around us. It's just the way it is. We're a product of our society, of our environment, of our family. And while yes, there is that little bit of empathy in each and every one of us, and some of us are born with a slightly better aligned moral compass than others, I'll just say. Or at least I don't like to argue that, I don't like to think it. Simple fact of the matter is, that's not the way it works. And that's an unfortunate thing. I truly wish people were born with the kind of morality that I have in me now. And admittedly, in my case, that might have not always been the case. Matter of fact, I'd probably admit that it wasn't. I hope you understand. I hope you get it. I don't think you will. And honestly, that kind of makes me sad. We all have our own views of morality. And if we all had the same morality, then morality wouldn't change. It'd always be the same. But we do. We do change. We evolve. We get better. And as much as I look at some of these people that do some of these horrible things and think, my God, what is wrong with mankind? I look at us as a whole. As a people. And as a whole, we're getting better. And I take solace in that. Even knowing that there's no moral lawgiver, per se. That this is what we make. But you know what? The fact that we're slowly working to make things better. Something I think we need to be proud of. Well, this has been a downer of a video. Next time I go wandering around the web and go visiting somebody, I hope it'll turn out a little bit better. 13 Heathen signing out. Have a better day.